Hi guys, welcome to my channel, and today we're going to take a look at my altar and what's all on it and why exactly everything that's on it is there. You might have saw my first altar video where it was a little different, obviously. I was at a different home and I just recently moved, so now I actually have a bigger altar. This is just the bottom of it. There's a whole top part to it up there. And we're going to work from the bottom up, okay? And I'm just going to show you everything that is here in front of me. And yeah, we're just going to get into it, I guess. So, disclaimer, and basically to just kind of start things off, this channel is mostly dedicated to tarot readings and stuff like that, but also I want to throw like my own little spin on things and let you guys get to know me personally and get you guys into like my practice in specific and how I kind of work things. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to take a look at the other side of things, and also I wanted to put it out there, like I did in my last altar video, that you guys don't have to have a crazy amount of stuff to have an altar, okay? Really, like, if all that you have is a sage stick and a mirror and a candle, that could literally be your altar, okay? Your altar is just kind of like a sacred, safe space to, like, do your workings and things like that, where you just kind of feel like you can relax and be yourself in. So, yeah, it doesn't even have to have a mirror. I just choose to have a mirror at mine because I like the art of reflection. I like to reflect. So that's why I always find it necessary to have a mirror at my altar, but it's totally up to you and it's your interpretation. Like you can make your altar your own. Okay, so as far as disclaimers go, I think that's pretty much it. And yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get into what all you guys see here. Okay, so I guess we can just go to the back end of things and take a look. On the back left here, I have a box, and I kind of just put random like little things in there, like sage sticks or just like little things like that, tea light candles, things that need a place but are necessary to be at my altar. Okay. Then here, you guys see that I have a little cup, and in that cup, dish, or whatever you want to call it, is dirt, and this dirt is from a graveyard, and yeah, it's graveyard dirt, which I use in some of my workings that need that, like, extra push from spirit or the other side or whatever you want to call it. So yeah, I keep that here at my altar in case I ever need to work with it or anything like that. I recommend that if you go to get dirt out of a graveyard or anything like that, you keep in mind that you should always be respectful, okay? And don't just take, ask permission. I know that they're dead, but you should still at least show gratitude and thankfulness and ask before taking anything, and definitely be respectful about it because you are working with death at that point. So yeah, here I have this little pin that broke and I'm really upset about it, but my friend got it for me. It's Simba from the Lion King. I love it so much. I just keep it here because I like to look at it and it reminds me of my friend. I have a lighter because I feel like it is impossible to not use a lighter when you practice witchcraft. So yeah, I keep a lighter handy. Well, I try to most times, but sometimes it ends up floating away. But it's here today, so that's why it's there. And this little jar, you guys might remember this little jar from my last altar video. Nothing's really changed. It's my herbs that I work with. I keep them in there. I have some chamomile flower. It says, is particularly useful for those seeking good luck. Chamomile can be quite helpful when seeking love and prosperity. Its aromatic scent also helps soothe mind, body, and making it useful for meditation. So I used this, and it was $1.99 for a whole bag of it. I've used it
consistently. But yeah, you can probably find this if you guys have a local metaphysical shop, or like if you get online. I know Etsy has a lot of stuff like this, but it's legit and it's a full pack. It was a really great bargain. But yeah, I use this when I really want to like meditate or really just like take a deep breath and relax and, you know, just like get back to myself. I like to use it for that. You guys can make a tea with this stuff too. It's a really, really good tea. And yeah, I usually mix it with spearmint if I'm going to be making a tea out of it. And then I also have spearmint. Now, I like to mix that and the chamomile together in a tea, and oh my god, you guys, it is so good. It says, a great herb used widely. It can be invigorating for the mind, senses, and psychic awareness. Also, spearmint is used in dream and mojo bags to call positive, bright energy. So, if you don't know what a mojo bag is, it's something that kind of looks like this. Now, this is not from a medical physics shop or anything like that, but metaphysics, not medical physic. But yeah, it's just a random little like drawstring bag I got, and I haven't used it yet, but if I needed a mojo bag, I would definitely use this. You can put little herbs in it or crystals or whatever, come up with a little concoction and give it to somebody for whatever your intention is, love, luck, whatever it may be, or you can keep it and carry it around for yourself. But yeah, that's kind of what a mojo bag is. And then I have yarrow, which is my favorite herb to work with. As you guys can see, I've used pretty much all of it. And I will be getting more. I use it in my daily practices. It's very, very special and important to me. I love yarrow. I think it's just a really versatile, useful herb when it comes to witchcraft. So it says it's often used in hand fasting ceremonies and weddings to ensure long-lasting love. Yarrow flower is also helpful in spells of divination, also used to exorcise evil and negativity from a person, place, or thing. So yeah, it's really versatile stuff. Mainly I use it with stuff that involves love, but it can also be a really healing herb, and I use it in things that correspond with healing and things like that, which I do a lot of in my practice. Everything else in here is just some leaves, and I have some hand-picked sage from my mom's house. It's Russian sage, and yeah, I kind of just keep it in there. That's my backup sage. When I run out of sticks, I go for that Russian sage. And these little pieces of paper are, it's a sigil that I made, and kind of just spread it around in these herbs, so I keep that in there. I can tend to be a very unorganized practitioner, so it might not look as organized to some people, but it feels organized to me. It's organized in its own way, okay? So, moving on. I have a nice smelly gingerbread candle that is almost burnt down all the way. I'll have to be getting rid of that soon. And then I have, I don't know what you want to call this. This is literally just a piece of wood that I found, but it's my little poker. If I ever need something sharp, or, you know, like to stir something up, mix herbs together, or do something, this is like on hand for me, and I use that. So then I just have some little flowers for decoration. And then I have this little baggie of, not sure what crystal this is. It came in a little kit my mom got me, and it was not labeled. So if anybody has any ideas on what crystal this might be, post that in the comments below. I, however, am not so sure. But I just keep them on hand just because. Now this just basically is my jewelry. I have earrings, necklaces, and then I have a small pack of incense. I have a picture of my girlfriend when she was a kiddo, and these two slots are empty. So that's kind of also just like a kind of random box to keep things from being all scattered on my altar. So here I have my little sage stick, and which I use daily, and I will like ash in here, or incense. I will ash in here as well. I know that they're for the cones, but I don't really use much of the cone incense. I prefer the incense sticks. So
yeah, I kind of use it as my little ashtray. And then once it gets like too full and too obnoxious, I'll mix that all those ashes together for some black salt, which is really helpful if you're a practitioner. It's a really like versatile thing also, and can be used for like nearly anything. So yeah, I definitely advise if you do practice to save your ashes, because they can be useful. Here I have my tarot decks, just a couple of them that I use on a regular basis. I have them out because I'm actually about to do another tarot video after I'm done with this altar video. And I think that Aquarius is going to be first this time because you guys had the most views. So that's also how I'm going to do things with tarot. If whatever has the most views, it's going to go in that order from here on out. I did the first round of readings in order, but now it's going to go based off of what gets the most views. So Aquarius is definitely first, and then I think it's going to be Pisces. So here I have my Himalayan pink salt lamp, and yeah, this just kind of sits here to purify the area and keep it cleansed and productive, and yeah, just like a really balancing energy is brought in by the salt lamp, and it's very protective as well. So and Himalayan pink salt is like that in general. It's to me better than regular like granulated iodized salt. I would much rather use Himalayan pink salt. So it just has more of a protective property to it, but you can use salt as well too if you don't have it. But yeah, I just really like pink salt. Back here I have a couple. Ooh, I dropped one. No. It was eucalyptus, you guys. I had eucalyptus and now I just dropped it behind my altar. I'm gonna have to go fetch it. But this is jasmine. I like to use jasmine on a daily basis too. This is good for like love spells and stuff like that, but it also has other properties to it that I'm not going to get into all of them right now. Maybe I can make a video about that later. All my oils and what their properties are. So yeah. And then I have, now this one's nearly empty, but I have rose oil, which I love. I like to put that in my bath. Yes, girl. This is good for like beauty spells or love spells too. But also, like I said, with the jasmine, there's other properties to it as well that I'm just not, I just don't have the time to get into all of that right now. But yeah. So I have those out because I use them frequently. And then I have my little mojo bag that I showed you guys. My jewel, which is not really part of my altar. And then I have this little glass decorative jar, you could say, I guess. But it kind of just has a bunch of stuff in it. So I have some salt in here that has some like burnt sage in it that I will use. This is the what I will use with the ashes over here to concoct the mixture to make some black salt. So yeah, I'm saving this little baggie of salt for my black salt when my ashes are ready. And I have a bobby pin, and I have some heads up pennies for good luck. So that's what's in there. Let me get that lid on right and get this bag in the whole way. If you're wondering what that is, guys, no, it's not a weed. It is dill. I had a little mishap and I spilt my dill all over the place and it fell all over my altar. So I'm going to just leave it. I know it probably seems like I'm a mess or whatever, but dill can be really protective and have a protective energy about it. So I don't see any harm in it just chilling right there. So that's what's going to happen. I'm just going to leave it there. And then last but not least for the bottom half of this altar would be, well, actually, yeah, I have this mirror. I love mirrors. I have multiple mirrors. And yeah, but I use this one to lay my tarot cards down on when I do readings and stuff. It's kind of just like a little like base to sit things on. I think originally it was for candles to mount on, like pillar candles and stuff, but I don't use it for that. Yeah. And then I have my altar bell, which I ring for spirit, whatever deities I'm working with, and I also ring it to clear the air in the space that I'm in. So
We have that. And now we're going to move up a level.
Oh, I almost fell, you guys. Just so you guys can see it in full. That's what we're working with. And then that's what the bottom looks like from afar. Now, when I'm done, like, for the day, I'll take this cute little blanket that I have, and I'll pull it down over my altar completely so that it's just kind of, like, covered and closed off, and so that the mirror is not just, like, pointing at me in my sleep. I truly believe that mirrors are portals, so I like to, like, cover them up and make sure that there's nothing, you know, like, staring at me in my sleep. So I also forgot to show you guys my little candle. Yes, it has melted away pretty much. It's still light, so I'm not throwing her out just yet. When it does melt the whole way down, I will throw it out and get a new one. But you guys might be wondering why there's candy there and one headphone. And it's because I do call upon deities, and I work with the specific deities, and I like to leave them something sweet as an offering. And I have the headphone so that she can listen to music, okay? And yeah, sometimes I'll put my sage stick in there to kind of like hold it, but now that I have that ashtray, I no longer do that. And yeah, I am aware that I need a new candle. I just haven't gotten to it yet, and that one's still light, so I'm not ready to throw it away. I like to use everything to its fullest and not be wasteful. So, and then I just have a couple like sage leaves and regular leaves just chilling around there because I'm a nature lover. I am a Virgo. I'm an earth sign, and I love nature. I love flowers. I love leaves. I love all of it. So that's what's with all the decorativeness with all of the plants and everything. Yeah, I'm just a nature lover. I think it's beautiful, and it really just brings life and positivity to my altar. So now let's actually go up top and check out what is up here. Let's start this way. So back here I have a picture of me and my son, because the deity that I work with, I want them to work with my family structure, my family life, and keep things positive in that aspect. I also call upon her for other reasons, but that's just why the picture has been chosen to be at the altar. Below that, I have my fiance and I's adventure fund. It is currently nearly empty, but that is not the point. The point is it is there and we are trying. I have a fake candle that I use sometimes if I don't have like real candles, if I run out of tea lights or something. It's the thought that counts and the intent that counts. And I have a little stick of Palo Santos in there. Now over here I have a chalice, and in my chalice is all of my offerings that I give to the deity that this altar is dedicated to. So there's many offerings in here. I go and usually put something in there daily. You don't have to if you're working with a deity, but just whenever you feel the intuitive nudge to kind of offer something to your deity, it's important that like you acknowledge them and let them know that you're thinking of them and that you recognize that they're there and you appreciate them and their workings. And so in a sense, you're kind of worshiping them. So that's what the chalice is for. And yeah, there's many offerings in there because I've had her set up for quite a long time. Over here I have, this is new to my altar. I just got this made and put up today. This is a chalice of rose water. Now, I haven't decided whether I want to keep this at my altar or use it for my personal. I might go ahead and just split it in half. Half for me and half for my deity that I'm summoning. But yeah, it is rose water. And there's so many beneficial aspects when it comes to rose water. You guys, you can use it for a facial cleanser, a moisturizer. You can use it in beauty spells, love spells, healing spells. There's so many different things that you can do with rose water. It's extremely versatile and it is extremely beneficial for your health. So I definitely recommend making rose water if you get the chance. All you really have to do is boil some water and get some rose petals,
throw it in the boiling water, stir it up for about a minute, and then turn the water off, let it cool down on its own, and then you can dispose of the rose petals, and then you have your rose water. Now, I do dispose of my rose petals, but I also make sure that I save a couple that I don't put in the boiling water, and I like to give them back to the earth as like my thank you for the earth being there and letting me use it for my own benefit. And yeah, I like to give back. So that's my rose water. And then I have this ginormous cluster of clear quartz. I believe it's clear quartz. I'm not really sure what it is. I picked it up at a yard sale, but it has a really positive energy to it. I that's why I have it here at my main altar. And yeah, it's just really pretty. And I don't think there's really any negative aspects when it comes to crystals, unless you get like a cursed one or a hex one, or if you don't cleanse it after you get it from somebody else. But yeah, if it's all good and it's all clear and cleansed, there's no like negative aspect to a crystal, because they're natural, they come from the planet. I'm just not sure of what it is, so I'm probably gonna have to take it to some type of metaphysical shop and have it identified for me. But yeah, I like to keep it up at my altar just because it's really, really pretty. So that's that. And then I have my little incense holder. I burn a lot of incense, you guys. As you can see, I got a lot of stuff building up in here. And I'm going to use all of that for my black salt. So, and I have a nice little cloth at the top. And then over here, I have one over here too. I have my two little torches that I'll sit either a long stem candle in, or I'll set tea lights on top of it. So, but also I like to put, when I don't have those things, I'll put little offerings inside there, because there's like a little dip inside. So I'll set some offerings for my deities in there as well. Now over here in this little glass, almost like a potion jar, I just have my salt. I always have salt on hand. I feel like that's like a really important ingredient for someone who practices witchcraft, okay? Salt, I feel like, is very, very necessary. So I make sure I always have some of that. And then here I have dill. I work with dill. I think it's a really, really protective and strong herb to work with. The next one I have is nutmeg. Oh my gosh, guys. Nutmeg smells like... Let me sniff it. Ugh. It just smells like burnt. Burnt something. Like, it just has a burnt smell to it. I don't really prefer the smell, but it's a strong herb and it has really good properties. And then I have cumin. I love, 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 love the smell of this stuff, you guys. It smells insanely amazing. I love it so much. So I have those at the top because I just kind of started this altar, and yeah, when it comes to like grounded herbs like these, I don't have many. So yeah, that's why those ones are in a different place as these ones, because these ones are grounded and those ones are more like seedy or like leafy. So I kind of keep them separated because I would use them in different ways, if that makes sense. Up at the tippy-tippy top, I have my two. That one's bent a little bit, and it makes me so, so sad. But, yeah, I'm not going to get rid of them because I love them. I have these two little candle holders. I don't know if you can see, I do have candles going in them. And those, I do that nightly. Every single night, every single day, I have candles going in those. Because, yeah, this altar is 100% dedicated to a specific deity, and I make sure that I am always, always, always showing my gratitude and worshiping my deity, okay? So that's just one way that I choose to worship. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna open this drawer here and check out what's inside. So starting at the left-hand side, we're gonna see that I am running out of tea light candles. I only have one left, but yeah, I have some tea light candles. I have some love notes from my fiance. I have my journals. Okay. Now, this one down here is more of a journal, like personal journal. This one is more of like a book of shadowy journal. I write like stuff that has to do with my practice goes in here. Yeah, so my journals, and then I have, my girlfriend actually got me this. Well, she's my fiance now. I'm still trying to get used to saying that. It almost looks like amber, real up close. It says handcrafted with genuine stones, but it doesn't tell me the stone. It is amber. I was right, you guys. It is amber. Okay, yeah, so I have this. It's really, really pretty. Really super awesome. So, I have that to wear. Another little journal. Now, this is more of like a random notebook. There's nothing really special about this notebook. This is just like when you need a piece of paper, rip it out. Or when you need to jot something down, rip it out. Inside, I have so many drawings from my son. He colors me pictures nearly every day and runs them into me. And says, here you go, mommy. So, I have those. And I have some really good smelling lotion. I have a bunch of pens and a Sharpie because when you're practicing, you guys, you need pencils and pens or a Sharpie or some utensil to write with, okay? It is super important because you're always going to have to write something down at some point. So, yeah. I have a random piece of paper because my fiance ripped a piece of paper out of my notebook and left trash in my drawer. I always keep some little good luck heads up pennies just because I am superstitious like that. I have stuff in here fall down a lot because it's a drawer, so it's constantly being open and shut, and I'm not really like the most patient or like slow person, and I just kind of like yank it open and things always be falling down, but it's all right, we can fix it. Back here I have a nail file, which I don't know if you guys watched my other altar video, but it's ruined basically because I don't have an eyebrow pencil sharpener, and yeah, I used my nail file to sharpen my eyebrow pencil, and now I no longer have a reliable nail file. I have this, like, poopy brown nail file. So, that's the that. This is just a card from a local plant shop that I came across. So, I have that. It's actually super cute. That is, like, the cutest card I've probably ever seen as far as business cards go. Here I have another tarot deck. I love this deck, you guys. I just have not read it with you guys yet. I will bust this baby out, though. I promise. I will definitely bring her out because she is a jumper. That deck is super active. And, I think whenever I get to the point where I have a bunch of, like, subs and consistent, like, viewers and stuff, I might do a giveaway, and that might be the first deck that I give away, because for a while I didn't touch it. Like, I literally was just like, nah, and got a whole bunch of other decks, and then one day I was like, I'm gonna give it a shot and give it a chance, and I sat down with it, and boy, it was like literally everything was flying out at me, and I was like, this is a really like active deck. I'm really connected with it, and this is just the instruction book that came with it. Yeah, so then I have a little, like, tarot instruction manual, which kind of gives you the rundown on everything. Yeah, so I have some coconut oil for my hair, you guys, because I'm random like that, and have some random shit in here, too. How could I not? That's just the person that I am. This is another tarot instruction booklet. I am bad at keeping stuff together sometimes. In here, I have two, more candles. White, because I always try and make sure I have some type of white candle, because white replaces any color you don't have. Like, if you need a green candle for a money spell and you don't have green but you have white, you can replace the green with white. It can literally be bent and used as whatever color, or it can be used as white, which is like a healing color, or whatever you want to set your intent for it. White is super versatile, so I make sure I always have white on hand. And this one is red, and I'm just saving this puppy for when I need to use it. I have a couple spells in mind that I probably use it for, so I'm waiting for the perfect time on this one. I had a green one too, but I already used the green, so. What are we missing? What else? Reading glasses, some chapstick, some cute little bracelets in there. Another lighter, yay. Okay, so it's gonna go up there. Okay, I have a vape in here too. It's dead. I don't have the charger to it. I'm not sure what happened to it, so it's just chilling in here for right now. There's some more dill that's spilt. And yeah, I have some matches because, yeah, like I said, when you're doing witchcraft, you tend to, like, usually always need fuego. I have a little tiny miniature pack of incense. And back here, I just have some more oils and herbs that I don't work with on a daily basis. Or I already have them out in another container, and these are, like, the rest of the contents. So, yeah, I have parsley. And you wouldn't think that parsley would have, like, magical attributes to it, but it does, guys. A lot of herbs do. Most herbs do because they're natural and they come from the earth, okay? So, really, like, I would definitely look at what's in your cabinet at home and research what the properties are with that specific herb. Parsley has a connection with death. So if you're into, I don't know, necromancy or summoning deities or anything that you would have to work with the element of death, parsley is a good way to get connected in that way. And then I have, this is just my dill that I had up top. I just have it stored back here. And then I have another little miniature pack of incense. I'm not sure what these two are, to be honest. I cannot stand when things aren't labeled, and it tends to happen to me often. So, yeah, that kind of sucks when I'm making a video, and I don't know what to tell you guys that it is, because it was never labeled to begin with. Geranium, I believe that's how you say it. It's bergamot and lemongrass mixed together, and geranium. So it's all three of that blended together. I haven't really played around with this much. The most that I've used this for would be the smell. Like, for my bathroom, I'll have it diffused in there, or my son's room, or anywhere that needs, like, freshened up. It's really a good cleaning agent. It's good to clean with. I've used it to clean my bathroom sinks and stuff, and yeah, it's super good for that because it has a really strong smell to it. But it's a good smell. Chamomile, you guys, I have that in herb form too, but this oil, man, is the bomb.com, especially if you want to relax. Like, the smell to it will just relax you alone. So yeah, I use oils a lot with baths or anointing candles or myself with it. So this is a really good one because it has good properties as far as, like, relaxation, meditation, and luck with it. But also the smell, like, you can't beat the smell. I'm not sure if I came across an oil that smells better than this one. Like, this one smells so good, you guys. Super, super good. And then this one, the label came off, but this one's jasmine as well. I have two bottles of jasmine because I love jasmine, you guys. It smells also really, really good. Jasmine was the first oil I ever got. As a practitioner, it was the first one I was drawn to, and I love it. I will never stop loving it. I'll never stop using it. I think that it can be added to nearly almost anything. Any spell that you're doing, or, like, worship that you're doing, or meditation, the smell alone is just amazing. And also, it literally has an association with love, so it will put love as your intent behind any work that you're choosing to do. So, yeah, I really fucks with the jasmine. So, I think that's it, you guys. I think you guys have seen everything. And, yeah. It is what it is. It's a lot bigger than what my last altar looked like. I don't know if you guys saw that video, but if you did, my altar was on the floor in my bedroom. And it was so small. There wasn't a lot of stuff in it. And we've upgraded, like, a month later to this, which I'm so, so excited about. Yeah, but I, even though I didn't have a lot of stuff at my other altar, I wanted to make the video regardless because I wanted to show people that it doesn't matter if you have all of this stuff here or if you have one or two little things. Like, you can still have an altar. You guys don't have to blow your life savings or feel like, oh, I'm not a real practitioner because I don't have a big altar or I don't have a lot of stuff at my altar or any of that stuff. Like, no, guys, none of that stuff matters. Don't let anybody tell you any different, because if you want to have an altar or you want to be a practitioner, that's literally all you need, is to want to be a practitioner. So you start practicing. Like, yes, an altar is nice, but it's not necessary, okay? You don't have to have an altar. A lot of people choose to have an altar, but you don't have to. And you can have a small altar. Your altar can be on the floor like mine was, you guys, okay? You can have 1 to 2 items at your altar. It literally is all up to you and how you choose to practice, okay? So don't let anybody tell you that your altar's not good enough because there's not a lot of stuff on it, or you have to have this, this, and this to have a correct altar. Like, there is no correct. There is no altar that's better than another altar. Like, your altar is sacred and special to you. So don't let anybody else tell you how your altar has to be, okay? I just wanted to share mine with you guys so that you could get a sense of, like, what's at mine and where I'm doing my tarot readings and why everything is where it is, and to hopefully give you guys some ideas too at what could be at your altars, all right? But yeah, so I think that's it. That is everything. And yes, there is a TV at my altar, you guys. No shame, because it's right in front of my bed. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video watching me show you guys my altar, and I hope that you guys learned something today and learned what you could do to create your altar and what objects you could have at your altar, okay? I hope that if you don't have an altar but you were thinking about starting an altar and getting one, I hope that this video has encouraged you to do so. I hope that if you can't afford a bunch of stuff for your altar but you still want to practice and you still want to have an altar, that this encouraged you that you don't need a lot of stuff. And I hope that you find a way to set up your altar and really make it your own, okay, you guys? Thank you so much for tuning in and watching this video. I hope you guys have a blessed rest of your evening, okay? And happy Thanksgiving and or fall equinox, depending on how you celebrate. But yes, make sure you guys click that subscribe button and the like button, and definitely come back for my next video, okay? Bye, guys.